So you've decided to make Wyoming your home. Congratulations. Welcome to the land of breathtaking views, Wild West charm, and no state income tax. But before you can truly settle in and call yourself a Wyomingite, there are a few formalities to take care of. But don't worry, it does not involve the DMV. We don't have DMV here. So in this video, I'm going to go over a few guidelines to becoming a Wyoming resident. But first, let me introduce myself. My name is Summer Robbins, your real estate renter located in beautiful Casper, Wyoming. If you are thinking about enjoying the free life here in Wyoming, please don't hesitate to give me a call, text, or email before you make your move. As a transplant myself, I know all the logistics and stressors of making the big move to the Cowboy State, and it's my goal to help make this move your best one yet. Not only am I a real estate agent, but relocation clients are my specialty, so reach out when the time is right for you. In the meantime, if you are enjoying this content, please don't hesitate to like the video and subscribe to the channel. All right, now let's get into becoming a Wyoming resident. Your first step to becoming a Wyoming resident is getting your Wyoming driver's license. The Wyoming Department of Transportation, or as we call it, WyDOT, is where you'll officially transition from an out-of-towner to a local. You have got 1 year after moving here to swap out that out-of-state license, but let's face it, you'll probably want to do it sooner than that so you can show everybody your cool Wyoming driver's license. Look at this photograph. Every time I do, it makes me laugh. Here's what you will need to bring in order to get that license swapped out. Number one, your current out-of-state license. Number two, proof of identity, like maybe a passport or birth certificate. And number three, you'll need proof of Wyoming residency, like a utility bill, lease agreement, or even a library card. And finally, you will need your social security number. After you provide those documents and take a quick vision test, you should be handed your new license. If your old license is expired, also prepare to have to take a driver's test.
So the footage shows her trying to stop the vehicle, but wrong pedal there, bro.
All right, now the next step to becoming a Wyoming resident is changing your vehicle registration and making your vehicle a full-fledged Wyoming resident too. And you've got 30 days from the date of moving to complete this task. If you are coming from California, you might get some dirty looks on the road until you get those plates changed, so I would recommend making it a priority. And here's what you will need to bring. You'll need to go to your county treasurer's office and bring proof of insurance, your vehicle title or registration from your previous state, and you will need to complete a VIN inspection form. Also, don't forget, Wyoming requires in-state insurance, so if your insurance provider isn't able to insure you in Wyoming, you will need to switch insurance carriers. I remember when we moved to Wyoming from California, we previously were insured through Mercury Insurance, and unfortunately, we found out once we moved that Mercury does not insure in Wyoming, so we had to change our insurance carrier. But thankfully, we were able to speak to a lot of locals here and get some great referrals. All right. Once you've officially set up camp in Wyoming, it's time to register to vote. No complicated forms or hoops to jump through here. Wyoming keeps it super easy. Just swing by your county clerk's office with proof of residency and ID, and you'll be all set. Or if you're feeling super adventurous, you can just register to vote on election day. Pretty cool, right? Okay, now moving on to the firearm enthusiasts. Let's talk about concealed carry in Wyoming. Now, Wyoming is a constitutional carry state, meaning that once you're a resident, you don't need a permit to carry a concealed firearm if you're 21 and legally able to possess a firearm. However, if you do travel frequently to other states, you may want to apply for a concealed carry permit to ensure that you comply with reciprocity laws in those other states. To apply for a concealed carry permit in Wyoming, you will need proof of Wyoming residency, a completed concealed carry application, a fingerprint card, and a background check. And for added peace of mind, I would highly recommend taking some firearm safety courses that can prepare you for responsible gun ownership. All right, moving on to hunting and fishing residency requirements. This is the ultimate Wyoming perk. If you're moving to Wyoming, you probably have a love for the great outdoors. Who wouldn't, right? One of the best parts of residency is the discounted hunting and fishing licenses. To qualify as a resident, you need to live in Wyoming for at least 1 year before applying, and you need to have a valid Wyoming driver's license or at least proof of residency. And since hunting and fishing are practically state sports here, establishing residency early gets you in on the action as soon as possible. And who doesn't want to brag about catching dinner or bagging that trophy elk, right? Okay, the final step, banking the local way. Here are some things that you need to be aware of about Wyoming. Wyoming does not have the big name banks like Bank of America or say Citibank, at least as far as I know. We do have a few Wells Fargo branches and a US Bank branch, and I think Cheyenne and Jackson have a Chase branch, but you're gonna really wanna focus on transitioning your banking to either a local bank here or maybe even a credit union. And our local banks and credit unions offer personalized service that really can be a benefit to you as a Wyomingite. So before you start worrying about where you're gonna bank, just know that the sooner that you start your relationship with a new bank here, the better off you're gonna be, because they can provide you with a personalized banking approach that can maybe offer you better lending products or banking products when the time is right. Wrapping up, becoming a Wyoming resident is probably a lot easier than you may think. And it's certainly easier than a lot of our other more populated states to the west or south of us. From getting that coveted driver's license to setting up your hunting permits and finding a local bank, each step gets you closer to becoming a true part of the cowboy state. And it really allows you to get back to what you probably enjoy most, which is our stunning Wyoming sights. So with that said, please, if you are thinking about making the move to Wyoming, don't hesitate to give me a call, text, or email. I am ready when you are, and take care, and we will see you in the next one.